how do centrifugal pumps work? What are centrifugal pumps for? And what are the basic principles of their functioning? We will find out in this lesson. The centrifugal pump is the most commonly used pump, both in industrial and civil sectors. This type of pump converts rotational energy of its impeller to energy in a moving fluid, so it transforms the mechanical energy first into kinetic energy and then into hydrodynamic energy. The basic principle of centrifugal pumps is to transform volumes of fluid from a region of low pressure to a region of high pressure. Thanks to this scheme, we are able to understand how this happens. At the bottom of this scheme, we notice the first reservoir containing a fluid, in this case, water. This reservoir represents our region of low pressure, while the reservoir at the top represents our region of high pressure. Initially, a part of water is already present inside the pump, and when the impeller starts rotating, the water is cut off by its plates, creating a region of low pressure. The pressure inside the pump is much lower than the pressure inside the lower reservoir, so there is a consistent difference between point A and point D. Thanks to this pressure difference, the water is sucked into the pipe and flows from the lower reservoir up to the pump. Now I'm going to explain to you how the water flows from the pump to the upper reservoir, thanks to the rotary motion of its inner impeller. To do it, I will use the Bernoulli equation. When the water is sucked from the lower reservoir due to the pressure difference generated by the centrifugal pump, there is some entry loss, which is a pressure decrease of water while it is entering into the suction pipe, and a pressure decrease of water while it is flowing inside the suction pipe due to the friction of water with the inner surface of the pipe. Same thing happens during the next phase, which is some losses while the water is entering into the upper reservoir, as well as it's leaving the pump entering the delivery pipe, and some losses when the water is flowing inside the delivery pipe, always due to friction. Having said that, we can apply the Bernoulli equation to explain in detail the different phases of water movement. I'm going to apply the Bernoulli equation at point C. PC by rho g, which is pressure, plus Vc square, which is velocity, by 2g plus the height, which in the scheme is Z1. So I get the total head, that is total pressure of water at point C, while it is entering into the pump. Very similar is the application of Bernoulli equation at point D, which is the point where the water is leaving the pump. So the equation will be PD by rho g plus VD square by 2g plus Z2. So to calculate the total head of the pump, I have to subtract from the total head of water leaving the pump the total head of water at point C. So, HD minus HC, what I get is PD by rho g minus PC by rho g plus VD square minus VC square by 2g plus Z2 minus Z1. So I will get H. HA value from this scheme represent the total head of water at point A. At this point, the pressure head of water is zero, because this point is open to the atmosphere. Also, the velocity of the water is zero, because in this point, water is not moving. The distance between point A of the lower reservoir and point F of the upper reservoir is HS, which is known as static head. Also at point F of the upper reservoir, the water is open to the atmosphere, so its pressure head is zero. The total height H in this case is HA plus HS. Having said that, it is possible to determine a relation between H and HS, applying Bernoulli equation at point A and point C. Like I already said, the water pressure at point A is zero, plus its velocity, which is always zero, plus HA. The result is the head at C. So, PC by rho g plus VC square by 2g plus z1. But I've already seen that between point C and point A there are some losses due to water entering the suction pipe, point A, and due to friction inside the suction pipe, point C. So the equation is complete writing z1 plus h inlet plus HF1, which is the friction in the suction pipe. Now, I have to apply the Bernoulli equation at point D and point F. I've already found out that the total head at point D, which is PD by rho g plus VD square by 2G plus Z2, which is zero, and which is the pressure of water at point F, plus the velocity, which is zero, plus the height, which is HS plus HA. But I've already seen that between point D and point F there are some losses, which are HF2, that is the loss due to friction in the delivery pipe, plus HE, that is the loss due to water leaving the delivery pipe to enter in the upper reservoir. So now I replace H of this equation with HF2 of this equation. What I get is H equal HS plus HIN plus HF1 plus HF2 plus HE. I get this because the difference between this value and this value is H, which is the total head of centrifugal pump. Now I can write H equal HS plus summation of all losses. I really hope you find this video helpful, and if you like it, leave a comment and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.